The EU is set to press ahead with new legislation to force multinationals to reveal how much tax they pay and how much business they do in each member state.
It is a big challenge. What I think is that it is important to have such a tax, because it's not normal that some big companies would make an enormous profit without redistribution. So this, the purpose of such a tax would be that. The point is, for Europe, you need unanimity to have it at a European level. So that is a big challenge, because some countries like the Netherlands, like Ireland, like Luxembourg, who are hosting the head office in Europe of these GAFA, are against it. So that will be a big challenge. But I think that should be the next fight for the following months.
Now, that is a problem for the whole world, and that's also a problem for the USA. Because if you have a bullying attitude, that means that you are, as a nation even, yeah, then you have a very big problem. Eh?
They can do whatever they want. That's what I think, at least. And that's where we have to be vigilant to say, hold on, guys, there are still laws to follow. This should be even arranged by the UN, the United Nations. They should say, guys, watch out. We watch you.
So the General Data Protection Regulation allows for EU personal data to be transferred outside of the European Economic Area, provided that the third party country in which the data are being sent provide for a sufficient level of protection. One of the bases on which such transfer can be allowed is called an adequacy decision from the European Commission. The one relative to the United States of America was called the Privacy Shield, and like we have said, it has been invalidated last year in 2020 by the European Court of Justice due to the American laws, in particular in the matter of state surveillance. So the consequences of the decision may be actually bigger than just covering the United States, as there is a chance that it also impacts the United Kingdom, for instance, South Korea, or even Israel. It is also, of course, having a huge impact on the American organization and its trading partner within the EU, as they find themselves without any solution.
On one hand, it's a little bit of fault of Europe. We were too lazy. We let all those companies, all those e-commerce coming into Europe and things like that. And we were not following. We were behind.
We have seen it under the Trump presidency. There have been already some sanctions taken by the US by raising custom duties on some European products. There is also a big fight around Airbus subsidies by European governments, and the WTO, the World Trade Organization, has issued also a warning on that. But I think we need to find a solution and a friendly settlement. It could be within OECD, regrouping the European governments and the US and Japan, because the growth of these GAFA can be also a problem for democracy, I think, due to the fact that these companies are more powerful than state governments. The debate will maybe be the partial dismantling of these huge companies. We saw it with the debate around Google, to dismantle part of it. It had been done previously in the 30s, 40s, with the big banks, with the separation between investment banking and retail banking? Well, why not try to have a debate at the world level on that, you see?